So this chapter name is, write down, first write down chapter name, then I'll tell you what it is. System of particles. So if ever you find, if ever you are facing difficulty in physics, this name will come first. System of particles. Okay. So why students find this chapter difficult? Because there are multiple things here. In this chapter there are like n number of things. So we have this habit as a student, we have this habit of doing everything at the end and just mugging up or trying to do it last minute of the exam preparation. So what happens is that if lot of information is there, you do not understand the link between the information, or you do not do enough problem practice, then you will get confused in this chapter which concept to apply when. You might be still confused in the other chapter because of lack of problem practice. This chapter will double it if you don't pay attention. If you ever miss, let's say 30 minutes of the class, you're daydreaming about something or someone, tum baith ke bas soch rahe ho, theek hai kuch to yahan pe main padha raha hu bebu ke se, and you don't pay attention, the entire chapter is gone. Because this is like a chain. Okay, why I'm telling you all this? Because see, the basic chapters are over now. Basic chapters are there in book 1. Kinematics is there, the laws of motion is there, warp energy is there. So these will form up basics. And then here is a chapter which tells you that till now you have been studying a special case about the motion of an object. For example, you always assume that this as a pen, this just slides forward like this with some acceleration. The entire object has some acceleration and some velocity. It is moving like this. You never considered that while moving, it can rotate also. Fine. And also, you have always considered one mass at a time when you are studying it. For example, whenever you have multiple masses and a pulley system, you draw a free body diagram of one mass at a time. You draw forces and then you get the answer and you feel happy about it, right? But then going forward, you are considering multiple particles together. For example, if there are like zillion molecules in this room, you're not going to study one molecule at a time, right? Oh, ye molecule kya kar raha hai now, what this molecule is doing. It becomes senseless. So you need to understand how collective behavior is what. As a collection of this entire, all the particles, what are they doing collectively? Okay, so this is what this chapter tells you, and this is closer to the reality basically. So we have learned the basics from special cases, now we are making it slightly generic. Fine. And when it comes to system of particles, each and everything is system of particles. This TV itself, multiple point masses, you can think of it, it is made up of multiple small masses. You can go to the atomic level, the atom is, let's say, smallest particle of this, you can say electron and this thing also. So there are zillions, millions of those particles are there, of which the TV is made up of, fine. So this is one entire, it may look like a single object, but this is actually a system of particle. But this is a special kind of system of particle. There can be system of particles like this cap and the pen. This is also a system of particle. When I am studying cap and pen together, what I am saying? Two particles I am studying together. So this is also a system of particles only. Alright? But they are moving independent of each other. The motions are not linked. But whereas in this television, when this television moves, this point will move along with that point. There is a definite relationship between these two. So their motions are related in some way. So studying this kind of system is easier, because knowing the motion of one particle, you can predict the motion of the other particle. But if system of particles have loose particles like this, then you can't predict knowing one particle's motion, right? This kind of system of particle, which doesn't get deformed, or they are depend, there's some relation, this is called rigid body. Fine. So we are going to study a special kind of system of particle which is a rigid body later on. Right? Right now I am going to just introduce a concept of system of particle. How to study any system of particle, whether it is rigid body or collection of particles like this, they are moving independent of each other. Okay? I think we have already started studying the system of particles. Kinetic theory is what? We have studied the entire, all the gas molecules together, what they do. Right? So, we have already started studying the system of particles. But here, we are going to study it in a different way. Okay? We are trying to apply the Newton's second law of motion. Then we are trying to find out the velocity of the system as a whole, and so on. Okay, so this is slightly different, but we have already started understanding the system of particles. Where else have we studied the system of particles, as in multiple particles together? Where have we studied? Where else? Collisions. Two particles coming and colliding. System of particles here, right? You found out the total momentum of the system. What it is? Momentum of entire system. And what is the system? Collection of particles. So we have already studied the system of particles. And fluids, what is fluid? Is it a single particle? No, multiple particles are moving. So even fluid is system of particles. So we have already started studying system of particles. First time we are studying it exclusively. Okay, so when we are studying system of particle exclusively, we are going to assume that we don't know anything. So we will start from the scratch. Fine. So whenever, suppose I have to start study, let's say particle. Like you remember when we studied kinematics, if you would have paid attention. So there, what is the first thing we have learned about the particle? What is the first thing about the motion that we should study? It's a point object. So what is the first thing you should notice about that point object to study? Huh? In kinematics there was no force, right? Huh? Rest? No. See, that is different. You studied velocity and acceleration and displacement. But before even you studied velocity, displacement and acceleration, what is the first thing? But that is an assumption. How you start studying it? You should first know the location, where it is. If you don't know where it is right now, how you know after some time where it will be? Isn't it? Displacement will just give you what is the movement, how much amount of movement. But if I ask you where it is after 5 hours, you should first ask me where it is right now. Then you tell me what is the velocity. If I just tell you velocity 5 meters per second, tell me where the object will be. You will ask me where it is right now. Okay, so the first thing about particle which we haven't studied actually systematically is the location. We have assumed that yeah, particle it has, wherever it is, that is its location, right? But when it comes to system of particles, there will be multiple particles scattered everywhere. So if I ask you where is the location of the system, it will become a tricky question now. Which location will you tell? Location of the first particle, location of the second particle, or the center of the all the particles? There has to be some logic to define what will be the location of entire system. And you should tell me, when I ask you location, you should tell me coordinates of a point. You can't tell me location of a system is starting from 0,0 to 2,0 and 2,2 and 0,2. 0,2. So you can't tell me that, right? Location is a coordinate. Right? So first thing we are going to learn here is how to quantify the location of the entire system. Suppose there are multiple masses scattered everywhere. How can I tell you where is the system? Right? So please write down location of a system. There is a special name for the location of system. It is called center of mass. Have you heard of the center of mass? Right? This is called center of mass. Write down the definition of center of mass. Center of mass is a point which acts as if entire mass is concentrated at that point. That is the way saying that center of mass is the location of the system. Okay? It acts as if entire mass is located there only. Alright? Now tell me, suppose you have one mass here which is 1000 kg and another mass here which is 1 gram. Your system has these two masses, only these two masses. The location of the system will be closer to 1000 kg or closer to 1 gram? Closer to 1000 kg, logical, right? So the location of the system should be closer to the heavier mass. So we will write it down. The location of the system should be closer to the heavier mass. So basically the weightage of heavier mass is more on the location. And this is the only chapter in which I don't follow the NCERT way of arranging the content, okay? I have my own way of. So don't match it up with, okay, this we have learned, this we haven't learned. We'll cover everything when the chapter gets over, then you can see. And yes, so the location is closer to the heavier mass, so the weightage of heavier mass is more on the location, right? So rather than finding, suppose this is my coordinate axis, please draw this coordinate axis, x and y, let us say. And the position vector of this mass is r1 and position vector of that is r2. I am trying to find the position vector of center of mass. Fine? So position vector of center of mass will be the weighted average, so that the position vector comes closer to the heavier mass. So it will be m1 into r1, m2 into r2 divided by m1 plus m2. Okay? Does it make sense? Suppose m1 is very large compared to m2. Automatically our center of mass will be closer to m1 because this term will be negligible. Get it? It is like finding the weighted average of the age. Like for example, some of you could be 90 year old, some of you could be 10 year old. But if 10 year olds are, let's say 100 people are 10 year old and only 2 people are 90 year old, the weighted average will be closer to the 10 year old. Same thing, this is weighted average. Have you heard of weighted average before? No. This is the weighted average. Okay? You assign weight. Alright. It is like suppose you have 1 rupee note. Sunlo. You have 5 1-rupee note and you have 100 rupee note. Total amount of money. What is the total amount of money you have? 1 into 100 plus 5 into 10. Right? You just don't count the number of notes you have. Similarly here, you are finding the weighted average. The weight of the position vector R1 is more. So you are multiplying M1 with it. Its weight. Getting it? So this is the center of mass location. And this is for only 2 particles. Suppose there are multiple particles. Suppose there are like 10 particles. Then what will be the formula? M1 R1, M2 R2, M3 R3, M4 R4 and so on. Are you getting it? So I am writing only for 2 particles, there can be multiple particles and there can be infinite particles also. So how do I write the, do you know this symbol, this summation of MIRI divided by summation of MI. This is the center of mass location. Make sense? Okay. But in this definition of center of mass is in terms of vector. Right? It is in terms of vector. Can I write the location of center of mass in terms of x and y coordinates of these particles? So let us try to see whether we can find, given the x, y coordinates of 1000 kg and 1 gram, what will be the x and y coordinate of the center of mass? Okay? So if I know the position, that if the coordinate of a point is x, y, what will be the position vector? X I cap plus y j cap. Right? So similarly, that is what I'll do. RCUM vector will be x center of mass I cap plus y center of mass j cap. This will be equal to summation of mi xi I cap plus yi j cap divided by summation of mi. Getting it? So this I can write as summation of mi xi divided by summation of mi I cap plus summation of mi yi divided by summation of mi j cap. So what will be x center of mass? You just equate the I component from left hand side and the y component also. So x center of mass will be what? It will be m1x1 plus m2x2 and so on divided by m1 plus m2. Y center of mass will be equal to m1y1 like this divided by the total mass of the system. Getting it? Is it straightforward? Okay, so you must know what is x center of mass, y center of mass formula, because we are going to use this quite often. Okay, any doubts?